يا حامل القرآن قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان والروح والريحان. يا حامل القرآن قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا بين يدي الساعة، وأدى الأمانة، ونصح الأمة، وكشف الله به الغمة، وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, one of the principles in Islam is الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. That is to enjoin, to command, and to instruct what is good, and to forbid, to stop what is wrong and evil. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّيَّ الَّذِي يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ يأمرهم بالمعروف وينهاهم عن المنكر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who follow the messenger, the prophet who can neither read nor write, whom they will find described in the Torah and the Injil, which are with them. يأمرهم بالمعروف وَيَنْهَاهُمْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. He will enjoin and instruct them of what of which is right, and forbid and stop them of which is wrong. By enjoining and encouraging what is good, and by forbidding what is evil, we protect the rights of the Muslims. It is not an optional act, rather it is a religious duty and means of drawing and getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is an Islamic principle and no one has a choice to take it or to leave it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the believers, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ والمؤمنات بعضهم أولياء بعض. The believers, men and women, are the protectors of one another. يأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر. They encourage people of good and forbid what is evil. And regarding those who have fallen astray and lost their track, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about them, المنافقون والمنافقات بعضهم من بعض. The hypocrites, men and women, they are alike and are from one another. يأمرون بالمنكر وينهون عن المعروف. They command and they encourage people of wrong and evil and forbid what is right and good. In a hadith, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من رأى منكرا فليغيره بيده فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه وذلك أضعف الإيمان. Whoever among you sees something evil, let him change it with his hand. If he cannot, then with his tongue. And if he cannot do even that, then with his heart or in his heart. And that is the weakest level of faith. This great principle in our religion is an individual duty on every Muslim. Every person, according to his position and capability, should fulfill this command. It is our duty to establish and train a group of people who are specialized to fulfill this properly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةً يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. And there will be a group of people among you inviting people to goodness and enjoying and encourage what is good and forbid what is evil. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And it is they who will be successful. And people who are specialized in enjoining and encouraging what is good and forbidding that which is evil, prevent others who are ignorant from doing wrong actions and guide them to the straight path and true guidance in a manner that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and beneficial to the people and the community they are dealing with. Goodness is a righteous deed. It is a justice and gives people their rights, while evil is indecency. It's offensive, falsehood, and oppression. If we abandon this principle of our religion, we will face problems in practicing our religion, and evil will overtake goodness, and ignorance will overtake righteousness. If we leave people to do whatever they like, the nation will collapse. If we leave them to fulfill their desires, they will transgress and will break the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will spread corruption and will violate people's rights while there is no one to remind them and guide them back to the truth. In this way, chaos will spread and crimes will take place. And then the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to all of them. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ النَّاسَ إِذَا رَأَوْا الظَّالِمِ فلم يأخذوا على يديه أوشك أن يعمهم الله بعقاب منه. When people see an oppressor but do not prevent him from doing evil, it is likely that Allah will punish them all. In another hadith, he sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِي لَتَأْمُرَنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَلَتَنْهَوُنَّ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ أَوْ لَيُوشِكَنَّ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عِقَابًا مِنْهُ ثُمَّ تَدْعُونَهُ فَلَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَكُمْ. By him in whose hand is my soul, you should enjoin good and forbid what is evil. Or else, it is likely that Allah will send a punishment upon you, and then you will make supplications and it will not be answered. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the general image and behavior of the Ummah is not owned by individuals. It originally belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after this, it belongs to the whole Ummah in general. So the individual does not hold the right to destroy the image by his bad behavior in claiming that he is free to do whatever he likes. We all are part of collective unit, and we must protect each other's rights. True freedom is that the individual finds a pure and safe community where his honor, his religion, and his life is protected. Is it not the right of the individual to breathe pure air and be able to live his daily life with the feelings of safety and security? The effects of the evil behavior of an individual falls on many people around him and negatively affects the environment and pollutes the water and air. For example, if there's a black spot on a white garment, the appearance of the clothing is ruined, is spoiled. So what if there are many spots and strains? This garment will be described as unclean and unusable. Therefore, we should try to stop all types of diseases and sicknesses that can affect individuals, society, and community. Promoting complete freedom without enjoining what is good and forbidding what is evil is the philosophy of non-believers. It is the methodology of a nation that was cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is still being followed by many nations today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. Those among the children of Israel who disbelieved were cursed by the tongue of Dawood and Isa, son of Maryam. That was because of their disobedience and violations. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, indeed this nation is different from others, because other nations, they were cursed as they failed to establish this fundamental principle. This Ummah is protected as long as we enjoin the good and forbid that which is evil. We should understand the importance of fulfilling this duty. We should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent this Ummah to lead people and to be pioneers of goodness, of righteousness and decency, and not the leaders in evil, wickedness and immorality. Therefore, we should not receive our instructions and guidance from any other nations. We must act upon the source of the knowledge that we have, and that is the Quran and the Sunnah. And to do this properly, we should have a knowledge of the sound creed and faith and methodology and how to enjoin what is good and what and then to forbid what is evil. We should have a sound creed to be directed to the right way. If people rely on their opinions and culture alone, evil will spread everywhere and people will live in chaos. Therefore, they must go back and refer to the sound sources of knowledge. They must go back to the Quran and the Sunnah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. You are the best of peoples ever raised for mankind. You enjoin what is good and forbid what is evil, and you believe in Allah alone. We have to understand this matter in terms of relationship between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His creations. And the purpose of creation itself, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانِ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. Indeed, we have sent our messengers with clear proofs and revealed with them the scripture and the balance, justice, so that people may observe justice and right mirrors. If people have correct belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by applying their thoughts on the correct sources of knowledge, then this will result in enjoining what is good and forbidding what is evil. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to benefit from the Quran and the Sunnah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the principle of الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر, the enjoining and encouraging good and forbidding what is evil and wrong, is a means of avoiding the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ لِيُهْلِكَ الْقُرَى بِظُلْمٍ وَأَهْلُهَا مُصْلِحُونَ. Your Lord, who will be saved, your Lord would never destroy a society unjustly while its people were acting rightly. So the people who will be saved are the ones who enjoin good and forbid what is evil. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, willful disobedience and evil actions are very dangerous to both the individual and the nation. It is a reason for decrease in one's provision, an unjust increase in market prices. It is a reason for oppressors to have control over people. The danger is much serious if the acts of disobedience and sin are done publicly and nobody denies them. The establishment on earth or destruction is conditioned by following the religion of Islam and following to its principles and rules. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ إِن مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَآتَوُوا الزَّكَاةِ وَأَمَرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَنَهَوْا عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. These are the people who, if we give them power in the land, they will establish the prayer and pay zakat, and they enjoin good and forbid evil. وَلِلَّهِ عَاقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ. And the final decision of all affairs is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the establishment on earth can be achieved by following Allah's commands. And most important of that is to establish the prayer. The establishment on earth cannot be achieved by spreading corruption or new innovations. Establishment on earth has a clear methodology. It demands building and construction, not destroying. And it demands reforming and improvement and not corrupting. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the truth as true and grant us the ability to follow it and show us the evil as wrong and help us to avoid it. وَعْلَمُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَكُمْ بِأَمْرٍ عَظِيمٍ أَمَرَكُمْ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالسَّلَامِ عَلَى نَبِيِّهِ الْكَرِيمِ فقال تعالى إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وارض اللهم عن خلفائه الأربع أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم بعفوك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين وانصر عبادك المؤمنين. اللهم اغفر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان والروح والريحان يا حامل القرآن. قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان.